You will be aware it was hopefully a day of reprieve for some people in care homes yesterday, and that they were able to be visited and even perhaps taken to a garden or for a walk or whatever. But you may not be aware that sadly a lot of care homes are saying they don't have the facility, they don't have the staff, they have concerns over insurance, the whole thing. Currently it's advisory from the government. Should it be mandatory, do you think, Minister?
Well, I think my message to care homes is, and they've been, you know, on the whole, really brilliant at working with us, with the social care minister, Helen Whateley, is, you know, we want people to have the best possible outcome. You know, the residents of care homes were prioritised for the vaccination programme. This is the time to try and implement this. I would much rather...
But they're running up against a brick wall or a bolted door, of course, Minister.
Well, Helen is working very hard to make sure that we engage with them. I've been part of conducting a big telephone exercise with the care home managers to make sure we understand how we can increase the uptake of the vaccine amongst staff as well. And they've been very proactive in working with us on that. And my message to them is, please, please, you know, where you can, work with us to make sure those residents really do get the some of the freedoms they deserve.
But you can understand the frustration from some of my listeners. They're desperate to see Grandad or whoever it might be. Totally, and the care home, totally, possibly for all the right reasons, is saying no. I'm just wondering whether we can put a little more effort into this, Minister.
Well, I can assure you that Helen is absolutely focused on this, right, because you know, we all know in the department, because we live it every day throughout, right, this pandemic, how important it is that those families are able to visit, that they get all the positive outcomes of this incredible vaccination program. I'm not going to repeat all the stuff you said at the beginning, but it is that the nation coming together. It's that if the virus challenged liberal democracies, because the only way we could suppress it is to withdraw freedoms with the non-pharmaceutical intervention, the dreaded NPIs, the vaccine program has played to the DNA of the peoples of these isles.